We already know what real numbers are. These are the numbers that can be represented on the number line. We also know that real numbers can be broadly classified as rational and irrational numbers. Rational numbers are those that can be represented as ratio of two integers with no common factor. Irrational numbers, on the other hand, cannot be expressed as ratio of two integers, and when expressed in decimal notation, they are non-terminating non-recurring decimals. Are there any other kinds of numbers? Numbers that we haven't looked at yet? Before you answer that question, let me ask you another one. Can you think of a number which when squared results in a negative number? Yes, a number which when multiplied with itself gives a negative number. Try it. You'd have probably tried a few options. 3 times 3 is 9, positive. Negative 5 times negative 5 is 25. Again positive. Negative root 3 times negative root 3 is 3. Positive again. No luck. We'll come back to this. Don't worry. So we've studied quadratic equations in middle school. We know that if x squared minus 9 is equal to 0, x is either equal to 3 or negative 3. Now try to find a solution to x squared plus 1 equal to 0. Not sure? Or do you think there's no solution to this one? Don't worry if you couldn't get the answer to these two questions. Let's understand the situation now. Whenever we considered the square of a number, say x, the result was always positive, whether the number x was a positive real number or a negative one. We always got a positive result. And we had learned that a negative number did not have a square root. So if we had a number like negative 9, we said that its square root did not exist. Do you remember that while finding the solution of a quadratic equation using the formula, if the discriminant b squared minus 4ac was negative, we said that there are no real roots of the quadratic equation. Based on what we had studied earlier, x squared plus 1 equal to 0 will not have any real roots as the value of discriminant is negative 4. Why did we do this? What was the problem here? It's easy. As the square root of negative 1 did not exist for us, we said that there was no solution for the equation x squared plus 1 equals 0. However, in the 16th century, it was a mathematician named Cardan who first started thinking about solutions of quadratic equations with negative discriminants. Soon, others started too, but it was Euler in the 18th century who gave the square root of negative 1 a symbol I and called it the unit imaginary number. These were termed so as they were thought to be impossible and just something we imagined. So I was assumed to be a number whose square is negative 1. Now you'll be able to answer the two questions. Can you think of a number which when squared results in a negative number? Yes, it's I. If square root of negative 1 is I, what is I times I or I squared? It is root negative 1 times root negative 1. That gives us negative 1. There you go. We got a negative number by squaring a number. And the next question was, can you find a solution to x squared plus 1 equal to 0? The answer is yes. Transposing 1 to the right-hand side, we get x squared as negative 1. Taking the square root on both sides, we get the value of x as root of negative 1 or minus root of negative 1. That is plus minus I. So what we learned in school wasn't incorrect. This equation has no real roots. Yes, it has imaginary roots. That's the concept of imaginary numbers for you. But wait, we understood the concept of square root of negative 1. What if the number is square root of negative 7 or square root of negative 9? That's what we will cover in the next video.